Who remembers the Club Burger? Or maybe this interesting building it was served in? Remember the chain? If you said Carrols, you'd be right. You might be wondering what happened to the once popular hamburger chain, and if so, stick around. Carrols has an interesting story, one that is not exactly finished. Hi, this is T-Roy, and you are watching Restaurant Rewind. What happened to Carrols? In the past few episodes, you'll remember we looked at different competing fast food chains, their beginnings, expansion, and subsequent decline. Today in this episode, we're taking a closer look at Carrols, a once successful hamburger chain that in the mid-70s had grown to one of the largest regionalized fast food chains in the northeastern United States, with over 150 restaurants. So, what happened to Carrols? The Carrols story starts in the year 1960. Herb Slotnick, a Syracuse area businessman, saw what was happening in California with the uber-successful fast food hamburger stands like McDonald's and Jim Collins' Hamburger Handout, and he wanted to bring back some of that success to New York. His plans for cheap, quickly prepared food were revolutionary to that area. Slotnick recalled, "Hamburgers were 15 cents, and milkshakes were 15 cents, and French fries were a dime, so it was 40 cents for a meal." Slotnick then worked with successful Tastee-Freez owners, Leo Moranz and Harry Axine, on the development of a hamburger chain, and buying the franchise rights for New York, he started opening restaurants in the Syracuse area called Carrols, named after Leo Moranz's daughter, Carrol. And so Carrols took off. In its heyday, many remember Carrols as the burger joint of choice for upstate New York. During the 1970s, other menu items included the sea filet fish sandwich and Carrols' crunchy country chicken. Carrols also formed an agreement with Good Humor to sell several of the favorite ice cream novelty bars. Carrols continued to expand through the Rochester market and at its peak had about 150 outlets, mostly in upstate New York and Pennsylvania. During the 1960s, a yellow slug character served as Carrols' first mascot. He was replaced in 1974 by a young blonde lad wearing a tweed suit and a fedora hat. You might remember from previous episodes that the 1960s were a great time to be in the restaurant business. And yet, as successful as many chains had become in the 60s, by the 1970s, many chains began to feel the pressure being applied by the larger chains. Carrols was no exception, and in the early 1970s, executives began to see that Carrols could not compete with the marketing power of its multi-million dollar competitors. In 1975, Burger King, for instance, had nearly 10 times as many restaurants as Carrols. McDonald's had even more, and these national powerhouses were taking a big bite out of Carrols' profits. By the early 70s, Carrols' restaurants were surrounded by McDonald's and Burger King locations. Slotnick recalled in an interview, "I felt like I was a target for a hit. Every time we had a good location, Burger King moved in. It's like Royal Crown Cola competing with Coke and Pepsi." So, Slotnick figured if you can't beat them, join them. And in 1975, he cut a deal to transform his company to Burger King outlets. Selected Carrols restaurants were converted to Burger King franchises, while the others were phased out and closed. The switchover was the financial shot in the arm that the company, now Carrols Restaurant Group, needed. Profits rose and the stock price quadrupled. By 1977, all but one of the Carrols U.S. restaurants was gone. That last surviving Carrols was on East Main in Batavia, which lasted until about 1981. The original menu of Carrols and the Carrols brand survived for a while overseas in Finland, Sweden, Latvia, and Russia. The last Carrols locations were purchased by Hesburger in the mid-2000s. So while the original menu and theme of Carrols is gone, Carrols Restaurant Group exists today as an American franchisee company. It had owned two Spanish-themed chains, Taco Cabana and Polo Tropical, but in February 2011, the company divested itself of those two chains to focus on its core Burger King operations, and rightly so. In June 2012, Carrols acquired 278 more Burger King locations directly from Burger King for approximately $150 million. In exchange, the Burger King parent, Burger King Corporation, took a 28.9% stake in the company. The transaction involved a line of credit that would be used by Carrols to renovate more than 450 of its Burger King stores. This makes Carrols the largest Burger King franchisee in the world, owning and operating more than 800 Burger King restaurants in 17 U.S. states. Carrols and the Club Burger may be long gone, but they'll be long remembered as a fast food favorite for years to come. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe now to Restaurant Rewind using the link to the right. Then check out the links on the left for similar videos. I'd love to hear your experiences with Carrols and would love to know what you'd like to see next, so please leave a comment below. I'm T. Roy. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Restaurant Rewind.